in your careers when you thought that you would not make it as drummers?
You know, it's a, you know, it's a tough business. We all know that, but we don't want it to sound like a cliche. Everyone says, oh, it's really hard music. But it is. But the thing is, it's kind of like having lots of strings to your bow, especially if you're a drummer. Like, I don't know, that's why I do production, that's why I do teaching, I do DJing. I mean, so basically if I'm not on tour for a month, I'll go and do something else, and not just rely on drumming.
I've definitely had a few classes along the way, and what a hell of a deal. And the thing that saved me was my mum. And I went to see a careers advisor thinking, well, I've had enough of this. It was late 20s, and I went to a career advisor in Norwich, and I was filled in a questionnaire and sat and talked to him, and at the end of it he said, well, I think you're probably looking at something like middle management or insurance. And that was enough. Well, actually it wasn't. I went home and I sat on my parents' staircase just with my head in my hands going, what am I doing? And my mum just looked at me and she said, you're a drummer, get on with it.
So I wanted to reach out and try and get sort of session work and freelance, but I didn't know how to do that. And I just got in touch, pretty much what these guys are saying, with people that I've met along the way. And just letting them know that I was looking to be, you know, like do freelance session work. It's important to have all these social media stuff and YouTube accounts and stuff. And obviously that works, but there's something to be said for having relationships with friends and people to play. They're playing with lots of people. I think the more styles of music that you can play or people you can play with, you never know what might lead you to the next path, so to speak.